Let's talk about coronavirus symptoms and what to do in case you do have these particular symptoms. So again, since this is a new virus, most of these symptoms are identified by reporting from patients who have acquired the virus. And what we know from these patients is that patients get a high-grade fever. It's not unusual for patients to have a temperature of 102, 103. That, a lot of times, is short-lived. It is also associated with shortness of breath, cough, sputum production. And unlike influenza, there hasn't been much reports of muscle aches or joint aches. So basically, this is a disease that is very similar to influenza in that it is an upper respiratory tract infection type virus, but unlike the common cold, it is way more aggressive, and unlike influenza, there isn't much muscle aches, joint aches, and again, there isn't any treatment that is known to improve this virus, and there isn't any vaccination for this particular virus. If you think you have coronavirus, you do not want to just go to the emergency room, and you do not want to go to your doctor's office. If you go to the emergency room and you have coronavirus, then two things are going to happen. One, most likely you will transmit this virus to people waiting in the emergency room waiting area, and could be even worse, you can transmit the virus to healthcare professionals, nurses, doctors, technicians who are taking care of you. Imagine an area where most of the doctors, nurses are sick with coronavirus, so you wouldn't have many people to take care of you anymore. Same thing applies to medical clinics. If you think you have coronavirus, don't just go to your doctor's office. Again, in the waiting area, there are a lot of people who most likely are sick. That's why they're at their doctors. And you do not want to give the virus to your nurses, doctors who take care of you, because then they won't be available to take care of you anymore. The best thing to do is to report your symptoms to your healthcare professional. And telemedicine is a big deal these days, and there's been more funding for telemedicine. So again, since in reality, there isn't any particular treatment for this particular virus, then if you report the virus or report the illness to your healthcare professional, they will probably advise you to quarantine yourself, to push fluids, to watch your temperature, to watch your shortness of breath. And if any or all of those worsen, then it's time to contact your hospital, and they will give you the proper techniques of how to get to the hospital. They would probably send the test kit home if, and hopefully soon, it will become available. And if you are, or you do have the coronavirus, and you are truly ill, then they would teach you how to put on probably a N95 mask, which is the mask that does prevent particles from getting out. And they would probably have you quarantined either at home or at the hospital with the proper hydration, discomfort type medications, and so on until the virus passes. We need to talk about everyday cold symptoms and then influenza and the coronavirus. So cold would be your plain old runny nose, sore throat, possibly headache, not associated with high-grade fever, and something that would make you feel really, really bad for 24, 48 hours and then would go away. Chances of you getting a cold this winter is pretty high. That's when we get colds. Fever is the big thing here. That's going to differentiate a cold from the other two big viruses, influenza and corona. So if you don't have a fever, up until today, most if not all patients with coronavirus have had a fever. So if you don't have a fever, then I would say most likely you do not have coronavirus. Now, differentiating corona from influenza is going to be more difficult because, again, the symptoms are similar. There is potentially more symptoms that are associated with the whole body when it comes to influenza, such as muscle aches, joint aches, potentially other type of symptoms. Whereas with corona, it concentrates on the lung. So yes, they both can cause high-grade fever, but coronavirus causes shortness of breath in a way that influenza does not originally. See, influenza can cause shortness of breath, can cause pneumonia, but usually not within a couple of days from the onset of your symptoms. So the one thing that potentially could be specific to coronavirus is that shortness of breath that happens close to the beginning of your symptoms. Influenza, again, the best way to differentiate between the two is to get a vaccination for influenza. So that if you get sick and you have all these symptoms that we described, then you probably have the coronavirus and not the influenza. But if you are not vaccinated and you get this illness and you get a fever, you get a headache, you get a runny nose, a little bit of shortness of breath, then you cannot be certain that this is this virus versus that virus.